Hello everyone, welcome to Blue Cube channel. In the continuation of the After Effects tutorial, in this video I will teach you the top 6 distort effects. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, I recommend that you do. First, I apply the Turbulent Displace effect from the Effects and Presets panel, which is very powerful. This effect is usually applied in compositions and, as the name of this effect suggests, it is used to create distortions in the image. We can choose the type of effect from the displacement menu. Smoother options also create smoother swings and more time to deliver. Vertical displacement only rotates the image vertically, and horizontal displacement only rotates the image horizontally. The cross displacement option also rotates the image vertically and horizontally. With the amount option, we can set the amount of distortion. Using the size option, we change the size of the distortion. If I change the offset option, you can see that the swings are moved. Also, by moving this point, it creates a similar result. The complexity option determines the level of detail in the turbulence. Lower values result in smoother distortion. And evolution, animating this setting leads to turbulence change over time. Evolution options provides controls that render the effect for a short cycle. Cycle evolution creates a loop that forces the evolution mode to return to its starting point. We determine the number of cycles here. Random seed determines the value from which the noise is generated. Finally, pinning specifies which edges should be pinned so that the pixels of those edges are not moved. I delete this effect and apply the CC lens effect. Now we seem to be looking at the picture through a lens. And the reason is that it bends the edges of the image in a circular shape to increase the curvature of the lens edge. In the settings of this effect, we can adjust the center, size and convergence. By changing the value of X and Y, we determine the center of the lens. Also, by clicking on this rectangle and then clicking on the desired point in the image, we determine the center of the lens. Here we can change the size of the lens. I increased the size so the lens covers more of the image. The convergence option basically determines the amount of distortion. I delete this effect and apply the liquify effect. The liquify effect allows you to push, pull, rotate, or zoom in and out on different areas in images and within a layer. We can select any of the liquify tools, and by holding the mouse button or dragging on an area, the effect will increase. By selecting each tool, the name of warp tools options also changes. In this section, we can adjust the size of the brush and the effect of the brush. I increase the amount of brush pressure and hold the left click on a point of the image. In this way, we can see that the effectiveness of the brush has increased. What we can do with this effect is that I first type a text and apply the liquify effect. Now I drag the letters down. Now I increase the amount of the effect using distortion. I click on the distortion stopwatch and set the time indicator to the 3rd second and click the reset option. I press the space button to play the animation. I select the layer and press U to see the keyframes. Now I will move the keyframes closer to each other to increase the speed of the animation. This is how we created this animation. Also, in the View Options section, I activate the View Mesh button. Now we can determine the size and color of the mesh. I create a pin using the Distortion Offset Mesh and drag it with one of the Liquify tools. I click on the Distortion Offset Mesh stopwatch to create a keyframe. I select the layer and press U to see the keyframes. Now I set the time marker to the first second and change the distortion mesh offset value. In this way, we also created this animation for the text. I delete this effect and apply the displacement map effect. The displacement map effect distorts a layer by moving pixels horizontally and vertically in the control layer specified by the displacement map layer property. I add the displacement map effect to the text and select the video layer as the map. You can select any video layer. Now if I press the space button, we can see that the text is animated. Now I click on the max horizontal stopwatch and increase its value. I set the time indicator to the second and set max horizontal to 0. I press the space button to play the animation. We can also animate the max vertical option. I delete this effect and go to the next composition to apply the pin corner effect. The pin corner effect distorts the image by changing the position of each of its four corners. As you can see, there is a screen in this composition. Now I put the image in the screen by adding a video to the composition and applying the pin corner effect. So, after applying the effect to the video, put the image in a frame by moving the pins. I press the space key. I delete this effect and apply the wave warp effect. The wave warp effect creates a wave that moves across an image. You can create a variety of waveforms, including square, circular, and sine waves. The wave warp effect automatically animates at a constant speed over time. Also, change the wave size in pixels using wave height and wave width. The direction option determines the direction of the wave along the image. And the wave speed option shows the speed at which the waves move. A negative value reverses the direction of the wave, and a value of 0 causes no movement. The pinning menu specifies which edges should be pinned, so that the pixels on those edges are not moved. Well guys, thank you so much for watching this tutorial till the end. Please like the video and leave a comment for me. Subscribe to see more tutorials. See you next time.